Fair enough. Alright, so now we're doing striking for characters from the battle box. You want to go first?
Sure. I'll take this one out. Too symmetrical.
Yeah, just a lot. I will take out... much as I like... I think I want to keep Rofellos. Oracle. I'll take out Oracle. That's a lot of life to start out the game with. And the effect is not stupid, but what is it? You may untap any attacking creatures.
You control.
So
you just make any attacks
combat.
You want.
Yeah. And then not have pseudo-vigilance, but you have to remove them from combat, so you maze of it your own creatures.
Yeah. It's like, You can, if you want to attack with some creatures but not all, You can just attack with all and pick
make
the one or two
tricky.
good attacks.
That'll do it. Alright. So from this, let's see. And then shuffling because there's nothing else to do. Alright. I know which one this is not. Okay. Oh, Rofellos versus Eladamri.
Interesting.
Aren't they both elves, I believe? I know Rofellos is.
Yeah, they
of
both are. They're both kind of. Well, Eladamri's an elf lord.
Yeah.
He just gives forest rock, right?
Starting life plus something. 15. I forgot about that. Oh, that's fine. Okay, so you'll start with two fewer, which in battle box means two, and I'll start with one fewer, which is three. But I'll start with 35 freaking life. Alright, six. Versus, okay, I'll take that. I'll be on the play.
Okay.
This feels very different already than yesterday, just by having fewer cards. I will grab my coffee at instant speed. That was totally fast enough to be instant speed.
That might have been an interrupt.
Oh, old school. Yeah, I'll keep.
Actually, I think coffee is a mana source.
Oh, it feels like it on days like today. Man, it is... I like it outside, but it's nice and wet. Icky. As my mom would say. Alright. Yeah, I'm keeping.
Me too.
Let us start off with... a Dimir Guildgate. Pass the turn. Since we have fewer cards in hand to start, I have a feeling this is going to be more...
Pass turn.
Yeah, start off with tap lands. That'll be more common. Whoa. Looking familiar. Looking like yesterday.
Familiar, you say?
We'll play Timber Gorge tapped. It's supposed to be a Gruul Guildgate. Sorry. Pass turn. Functionally, they're the same, though. There aren't any cards that care about gates in here, right?
No.
Okay, in that case, we're good. Mm-hmm. Nice, dark, roasted...
Play an island.
Taste. Okay.
Played a Geopede. Your turn.
That seems pretty good. No shadow anymore, though, so... That's... very different than it was yesterday. That's good. Huh. Let's see. So draw. Ooh. Very interesting. I will play a forest. Say hello to a sprouting Thrynax.
Oh boy.
3/3/3/3. Woo! Pass turn. Leovol would be so proud. The vast network of predation on Jund has actually caused some strange creatures to adapt to being eaten.
Mm-hmm. Play Selesnya Guildgate. Swing for three.
Rar. Alright, take it. Go to 32. I think I might want some dice to represent that. I'm sorry. That's a lot. Or actually, my phone is on the other side. I'll just grab that. Get a life counter app out. That'll do. Anything else?
Nope.
Alright. One quick sec. May have to turn the brightness up a bit. Maybe. No, I think that's good. I think we're alright. I'm 32. You start with, what, 4 greater life? I think? Yeah, 4. So you're still at 24? Alright.
Good.
Swing for 3. Uh-oh.
Play Warped Physique.
What is Warped Physique? Target creature gets plus X minus X till end of turn, where X is the number of cards in hand, which is 3. I will disrupt that.
Ooh.
And I'll draw a card. Yeah, this is looking really familiar. Alright, so 3 is good. I will drop a... I'll drop an Azorius Guildgate, and then pass the turn back to you. Disrupt. Pretty good.
Play Demir Guild yet. 7 for 3.
Come at me, bro. Uh-oh.
Play Necrogen Scudder.
Alright, drops you down to 18.
Pass turn.
For a 3-3 in the air. Untap you too, buddy. You don't get out that easily. I'll swing at you for 3.
Take 3.
I'll play a Steward for some ramp and a Frostburn Weird.
Okie doke.
And then follow up with Arakdos Guildgate. Pass turn. To get all of my colors. And then some.
Play Necrotal. Sprouting Phyrnex.
It's black.
Oh, non-black. Oh, right. I'll kill your Frostburn Weird.
That's the right one. Yeah, Necrotal. Sorry, buddy. Yeah, he's a terror, so non-artifact, non-black creature.
Let's play Azorius Guildgate. Swing for 6.
Alright, take 6. Put me to 23. Is that show? Yeah, it's showing up.
Go ahead.
See what I get. Ooh. Okay, that's fun. It's all well and good. I'm actually not sure that that's the right play this time. We'll make it, though. I think that we're good. I think we're safe. Black. 1, 2, 3. We will putrefy your first striker.
Yeah.
Make combat a little easier. What's the card draw from? Oh! Yeah, very good. All right, I'll swing at you for 5. And then I will play a foul imp. Lose 2. Meet a 21.
Okay.
And then pass the turn. If this format didn't already have a name, I like Endless Horizons, because it gives you effectively 2 draws. You get your land and you get a non-land every turn. You know, that white enchantment that definitely does not work in Battle Box.
Your folk leader.
Fair enough.
Rule Guild Gate.
Landfall.
Pass turn.
Uh-oh. What you gonna do? How about Puppeteer Click? I will take your Necrotal. Injures the battlefield, put target creature from an opponent's grave on the battlefield under my control. Gains haste, and then at the beginning of the next end step, I exile it. So, Necrotal is going to hit...
1-1. First strike or 1-1?
Yeah, the looting is... It's real good, obviously. And either way, you're about to draw a card. Yeah, I think we have to hit the first striker. And then, yay for card draw! On that note... Let's see... I'm not done yet, I'm debating. Now we're actually going to swing with the whole team. 3-3, 2-1, because it's going to get exiled anyway, Steward, and Foul Imp. Uh-oh.
Play Drumar's Charm. Give Steward -2/-2.
Rip. Rip and pepperoni, bro.
Block here and block Thrynax.
Alright. The damage that would be dealt to Foul Imp, I can direct to myself. I think I misplayed here, actually. I did. Well, the 3 that would be dealt to Foul Imp... No. I only have to direct 2 so that it has 1 damage mark.
Any amount of damage.
Yeah, so I'll direct 2, actually, to save the Imp. And then you'll take 2 from Necrotal. Now, the misplay is that I have a card in my hand that I could have... played there, but that's okay because this gives me the chance to use the tap land instead. And then, yep. Oh, it's a yeah. That dies. And then your Necrotal is exiled. And then pass turn.
draw. Swing three.
Block with a click.
Okay.
It does fly.
Are you directing damage?
No, I'm going to let all of it come to click.
Okay.
Doesn't have any trample. Trigger. We will take... Doesn't really matter because it's at the beginning of your next instep. Never mind, so it does matter. I'll take the... Probably plated geopede.
Oh, I'll draw for scutter.
Yep.
Okay.
All right. And it has a counter on it. A little persist counter. A little death counter.
Merciless eviction for creatures.
Yep. Yep. Exile all of it. That'll do it.
Mountain. Did make us elemental.
Ooh.
Pass turn.
Okay. I respect that. How about... We tap differently. Oh, it doesn't actually matter. Fleshbag Marauder. Yay! Bears!
Bearscape. Making two bears.
Not quite enough mana yet. I have only one left, so I can't use the ability as well.
Oh, I see.
But I will pass the turn. Yep. Oh, wait a minute. It's three How can I not read?
You can make a bear if you want.
Jay. Shame. Thank you. Shame. Right. Wake up.
Tap,
needs more coffee. Please insert more coffee to continue. Yep. Also, awesome art. Seeing the bears and everything.
Esper Charm, destroy target enchantment.
Yep. Seems good. Respect that. How many cards in hand?
Four.
Yeah.
Pass turn.
With well more than enough to regen. Alright. Put all my gates together. Even without any creatures, though, it could beat the bear. I know that this is the right time, but as good a time as any, I suppose. blue. Mm-hmm. 2, 3, 4. Five, six, seven. Take possession. It's split second, so.
Yeah, okay.
Swing two. Pass turn. I wanted something a little bit better than troll, but I'll take it.
Six mana.
Uh-oh.
Ether Snipe.
Ooh, okay.
Return the troll to my hand.
Oh. Fair enough. Rip.
And... pass turn.
Alright. See a 4/4 standing in my way. Let's tap Grixis for a Seagate Oracle. With 3 mana left, it does resolve, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Put it on the bottom, make sure it's turned the right way. We will Flame Slash your Aether Snipe.
In response... I'll play Cackling Counterpart.
Ooh, okay. Put a token out.
Get a token.
What would you like to bounce? I think as if he doesn't know the answer.
And it's not entirely clear.
Yeah, that's fair.
I don't know. I think I just want to kill your bear.
Yeah, that's probably right.
And draw a card. Man, I don't have any Aether Snipe tokens.
There you go. The bear has done something useful.
We'll use Kim Jong-un.
Oh, okay.
And, yeah, bounce the bear.
That scruff at the bottom. He has, like, a 17-point chin there. So all right.
This resolves, this dies, I draw a card.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
In that case, awkward... One, two, that still leaves all of my colors open. We're gonna go super hard on the aggro here. Strangle Root Geist.
Mm-hmm.
Swing three.
Only the Geist has haste.
Oh, did I play you this turn? I did, didn't I? Oh, Jay. Oh, I already called it.
I'll block it.
Yep. Trigger, gets a counter. That was lame. It's been so long, I forgot that.
It's alright.
Insert more coffee to continue. Pass turn.
Untap. Just have the slightest suspicion that you have a burn spell in your hand.
Maybe.
Alright, so my maximum hand size is actually 5.
Mm. That's right, because the modifier affects your max hand size as well. Although I'm worried that you have that many cards. And I have one.
Play a lot with Troll.
Hi, buddy. Long time no see.
I'll discard Sunscape Battle Mage to the Lotlith Troll.
Okay. That's the destroy creature with flying and draw two cards?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, the fact that we're doing this main phase, though. Yikes.
Playing Cytoplasm Rootkin.
Okay, that's why. And it gets four counters.
Mm-hmm.
And he can pay mana to move counters from the Cytoplasm to anything else. Although
from anything else with the 1/1 counter onto the,
yeah,
the Cytoplasm.
So what you could do, if you pay the two extra mana, you can, while that triggers on the stack, put one on the Aether Snipe so that
it only moves counters onto it.
Onto it?
Yeah. Graft makes whatever creature I play able to get a counter from it.
Okay. Huh, I misread that. Maybe they thought of exactly what I thought of when they were designing the card, so that you couldn't, in response to the trigger, put counters on other things to make them get extra counters.
Yeah.
Hmm.
I'll pass the turn.
Okay.
Six life.
Gotta love it. Whale. Pass turn. Uh-oh.
So, I'll play Bet Call.
Oh, God. Oh, God.
Resolved?
Yeah. You get four tokens and draw four cards. Boyds. The RK Post Boyd tokens. What a classy chicken.
Two.
And penguin.
Let's see.
This one has double flying. It's at the bottom end, it's written there too.
Yeah.
That'll work.
Alright.
New ruling, if a creature that already has flying is giving flying again, it flies higher than reach will reach, except in the case of double reach, etc. Okay, there we go. Yeah, the Born of the Gods birds are, I think, maybe my favorite. Need to pick up some of those. There's a game that they play on a TV show called Sarah and Duck that Evangeline really likes. Mm-hmm. The game is called Same Breads, and it's just if two cards match, then you call it, pick them up. I think it's like War is the playing card game similar to.
I'll discard Orcus Lumberjack to the Lolith Troll.
Yep. And that makes it a 5/4.
Mm-hmm. Swing for 5.
I'll Mardu Charm it while you don't have mana to regenerate it.
4 damage.
Uh-oh.
I'll discard a Carrion Feeder.
My god, you had all of the cards.
Well, I did just draw 4 cards.
That's true. In that case, I will... It has Trample. Mm-hmm. I will block with the Seagate Oracle and let it take all of it.
Just the Seagate?
Just the Seagate, but I have something to do before before we finish here. Okay. I will send it to on an otherworldly journey.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, seems good.
Okay. So I'll take... Let's see, I'll take 3.
No, you take the whole damage, right? Because it doesn't... Well,
Trample, but it has 3 toughness. So it'll die...
It doesn't exist.
That's right. Oh my goodness, Jay. Oh my goodness.
We're not playing damage on the stack.
No, we're not. And I misread the card. It's exile target creature, and then you get it back. Not when it dies.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh my goodness, Jay. You...
Well, you're taking 6.
I'm taking 6.
You get your card.
Oh my! This is on camera too. That's how this works, I suppose.
Yeah, I'll pass turn.
All right, so resolve its trigger. That's easy. There's a counter on it. It's just invisible.
Let's see if we can fix that.
Oh, thank you. You know, right on time, I guess. Swords, your Lotlith Troll?
Swords, my Lotlith Troll. Okay, yeah, I'm down with that.
Gain a bunch of life.
It's to its power, right?
So yeah, to 6. Its power. Okay. Right on time.
I know I have more dice than that.
Jay. Hmm. Misplays everywhere. That's okay. We'll, hear the Terminator theme? Is that it? Pop, 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 pop.
The birds are coming.
Indeed they are. Because I am an idiot, I am playing this in reverse order. I'll, gain control of your Aethersnipe token. Hmm. And yes, that should have been... Since it sacrifices it at the end of turn, I should have taken the Lotlith Troll instead of exiling it. And then I could swords, say, the Aethersnipe or the Cytoplasmic Ken.
Oh, yeah, gain life.
But I'm just way out of it today. So, will this resolve? Mana leak? Negate?
No. Yeah, it resolves.
All right. That's all right. We'll swing with... Obviously you. We'll swing with the team.
Okay. Block here. Play Harm's Way. Direct the next 2 damage that would be that he would deal to him. Redirected to Stranglery Geist. So I take 5, and then the Geist dies.
I'll redirect 1 from the Stranglery Geist to me, so okay. It'll have 1 damage marked. And... Yeah, the Aethersnipe token, Kim Jong-un, gets wrecked. That's a very good flavor.
Back down to 7. All right.
Yeah. And then pass turn.
All right.
And so you took, 5. All right.
Draw. So I think this works if I... If I cackling counterpart
the
cytoplasm root can.
Yeah. You make a copy of it, it'll put another counter on.
Trigger. Yeah. This, and then I'll graft onto this.
Okay.
So this goes back down to 4.
So that's 2 mana to do that? To move see what you're doing. You're grafting. Yeah. You're not using its last ability. Okay.
And then...
And then the birds. Alfred Hitchcock's The Birds.
I'll attack for 6.
All right. I have to take 6.
I'm going to play Crystallization on Strange Root Geist.
Yikes.
Pass turn.
Okay. It's going to make it real tough. It is actually impossible for this card to make as much difference as I had hoped in this match. I mean, Roar of the Worm makes a 6-6, but... Obviously, the way that that works. So I make a 6-6, I keep both of them back, and if you swing with both of these and all of your birds, you know, I'm going to lose one of mine, I'll go down to 2. I guess I'll
try. So it's not over right now.
Not quite. It's pretty close, though. May I have a worm token?
You may.
We have a worm. And they're alphabetical, right? Or no, they're not, actually.
It's too hard to keep them in order.
Fair enough.
I usually put them in color order. And then, I put, rhino, knight, elephant together for that one that makes 3 tokens.
Oh, okay. I don't remember its name either.
The Celestia 7 drop? Or I think it's, Yeah.
Yeah, pass turn after that. Then one more turn to dig.
Okay. Play Safi Eric's daughter. Sacrifice to... Target the cytoplasm root can, draw a card.
Uh-oh.
More cut Banshee, and I'll give that -4/-4.
Alright, good game. Good game. Game 2. After this, when we go back to the Legacy Gauntlet, I would like to jam Miracles. I haven't got the chance to play with or against that yet.
I want to play
Leovold. Oh, yeah. That's going to be... Whew! I'll be first, by the way. Okay. That's going to be huge. 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 I had to.
How many crads you drawn?
Oh, 7.
More like 3.
This is Battle Box. This is Battle Box with characters.
That's okay. Don't get ahead of yourself.
No. Okay. So we're off to a great start. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'll shuffle these back in just a second. I can still keep. And then we'll shuffle. And for those that didn't catch this, we've actually taken out the cards we played with in the last game so that we'll definitely get a different state this time around.
And no need to shuffle.
Yeah. Other than, you know, yeah. Me being me.
Theoretically.
Yeah.
All right, you're going first?
I will, yes, still go first. I will play a Plains Dryad Militant.
Ooh, okay.
Has turn. There's a card.
What up, young wolf?
Nice.
Go ahead.
Well, I don't think I really want to attack into that, but, I mean, Undying, there's not really a good point, really a good reason.
Yeah.
We'll gather the townsfolk.
Okay.
Let them do it for me.
I wish I had that card. Is it humans or soldiers? It's humans, right?
Humans, yeah. In the memories of those they lost lies the strength needed to defend their city. Although, a little bit of a nombo with Eladamri, you know, fateful hour is not a thing when you start with 35 life.
Yeah. You can get yourself down that far.
I believe you.
And yeah, I do have 5 humans for the fateful hour.
Nice. As Evangeline would say, nice.
Nice.
Best turn.
Okay. Yeah. Tap draw. Ooh. That might be the perfect blocker.
Uh-oh.
For a few 1/1s.
Oh, okay.
The 1/2.
Hi, Trapper.
Your turn.
All right. Play a Demir Guildgate and pass turn.
Sweet. Even when we have 1s and 2 drops, it's the slowest game.
Oh, man. I'm waiting for one of the several cards in here that says,
Slaughter
deals
Master.
1 damage. Okay, double strike. That was Modern Masters 2 limited. That's fun.
Your turn.
That's fun. I don't like it. Oh, hi, Lisa. I don't know. I guess we'll play. How about oh, well. Guess we'll get a mountain out. Fate's Fetters on the Slaughter Master.
Okay.
So,
even more life?
Oh, other way. Even more life. Can't attack, block, or use its ability. Although, if it can't attack or block, a lot of good that'll do. In any case, I guess we'll pass turn.
Well, end of turn, we'll trap your Dryad Militant.
Yep. Might as well.
Why not, eh? Draw. Yeah. Island.
Mm-hmm.
Stormkirk Noble.
Hi, Noble. Oh, look at all my humans here.
Last turn.
That can totally block that. Draw a card. Ooh. That's fun. It's all well and good. I guess we'll start off with look at all these weird abilities. We'll start off with a Nest Invader. May I have an Eldrazi Scion? Or not Spawn, Spawn, not Scion. And then we'll play a Vampire Interloper.
Oh boy. Flying.
And then we will play. Yeah, flying. A. How about. An Azorius Guildgate. And then we'll pass the turn and get our militant or our nest invader trapped. By the way, that's exiled. Thank you, Dryad Militant. Forgot about that.
Yeah, speaking of which.
Yeah, he can't block though. Interloper can't. So I have three potential blockers for Noble here.
Yeah, we'll tap the Nest Invader.
Yep, makes sense.
Tap, draw.
Okay. Yay for stall board states.
Woo!
Okay, all of the basics.
Hypersonic Dragon.
Flying haste, your sorceries have quicken, have flash. Well, the flyer can't block, so I guess I take it. Not much I can do about it. I'll go back to 35.
Your turn.
Let's see. So... Interesting. One of each color. See? Red, green, white, black, blue. Chromot.
Oh boy. Alright.
Yeah, he's a biggin. He's a biggin. I will swing at you with my flyer. It's not really much of a cost to do that.
Cool.
And yeah, that'll be it. Just the flyer.
Take two.
Okay. Then I'll play a. How about a Timber Gorge? And then I'll pass the turn, my friend.
Draw. Play Rakdos Guildgate. So Chromat is an illusion, I believe.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I think that's right, but of course all I see is legend, so I take your word for it.
I'll hang back. Pass turn.
Fair enough. Draw a card. Oh. Oh. Chromat. What a weird card, man. What a weird card. I love it, though.
He used to have an EDH Chromat deck.
I believe you. I believe you indeed.
Just most overpowered cards and then Chromat.
Would like to go to combat? We get to...
I'll tap Chromat.
Yeah, none of them give him Hexproof or Shroud. I guess it would have been Shroud back in the day. Alright. We'll have that be done. Now... Yep, okay, main phase 2. We will play a Selesnya Guildgate.
Okay.
And then we'll pass the turn. This board state, man. This freaking board state.
Play Phantasmal Bear.
Yeah, okay. That's cool.
Blood Scrivener.
Blood Scrivener. If you would draw a card and you have no... Okay. No cards in hand, instead draw two and lose one life. How many cards are in your hand?
Two.
That seems pretty good. I don't know. We'll find a place for it. Yeah, that's a thing, I guess.
Demir Guildgate. Fast turn.
Alright, Chromat, good to have you back, buddy. Gonna save some space by doing it this way. Let's say tokens over here. Tokens over there. Alright. Ooh. Alright, Beginning of combat?
Yeah. I'll tap that.
Yeah, you would. Oh. I mean, you look at that art, who wouldn't? Or actually, who could? Good God, man. Alright. In that case, main two?
Yup.
Crystal Shard.
Ooh. Okay.
Over here. Play an island and tap the island to target Phantasmal Bear to kill it.
Draw a card.
That you do. That's true. Pass turn. That does keep the Blood Scrivener down a bit. Scrivener. Hmm. try to be Dulcim one day. Lots of fun.
Play Nameless Inversion on Dryad Militant.
That's an interesting choice. I'm trying to think what the game plan is from here if you do that. There's something with flashback, maybe, I need to be worried about? Militant's dead. And Inversion's actually in the yard this time. Is it? It's not, is it, right? Because of the same reason Lightning Bolt would be exiled.
That's true.
State-based actions.
If it said destroy, that'd be different.
Yeah, that's right. A lot of good you're doing, Chromat.
Let's negotiate.
Fair enough.
I'll swing four.
I guess I'll take four.
Pass turn.
Draw. Okay. Okay. I like it. Kavu Climber? Draw a card.
Oh, yeah, that's good.
That's such a silly card. I love it, but it's such a silly, silly card. Beginning of combat?
I'll tap your... Interloper.
Alright. Chromot would like to... Chromat would like to swing. Well, first... No, I think this is right. I think this is correct. Could be wrong, but I think this is right. We'll give him flying.
Good.
Rawr! So, just five in the air? Just five, that's all. That's all I got. What do you say?
I'll play Forbidden Alchemy.
Okay, so let's look at the top four. One goes in your hand, the other in your grave. The other's in your grave?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, fair enough. Do you have to reveal?
Nope.
Nope, fair enough. So that leaves you with one mana?
I'll take five.
Okay. So waiting for an unsummon or a vapor snag or something to just wreck my day.
My turn?
Yeah, that doesn't do a lot of good. Pass turn. Uh-oh. I'm scared. 7 mana.
Click Romanticore on Stromkirk Noble.
Oh, that's pretty sick. Okay, and it gains everything. First Strike, Flying, Lifelink, Vigilance...
Trample,
okay. That's the green one.
And +4/+4. So I'll attack for 5. Attack for 9.
All right. Both flyers, so not much I can do about that. Yeah, Kakate Koi. Bump you up by 5. Drop me by 9. Wait, what was I just at? It was at 31, I think.
I'll play Girl Guildgate. Pass turn.
End of turn. Crystal Shard. Tapping this. We're going to return... how about... Kavu Climber to hand.
Okay.
Obvious shenanigans are obvious. And then untap everything. Draw a card. Oh, right on time, buddy. Right on time. Not at all on time. Well, so obvious play is obvious. So, Chromanticore will bestow, so it's an aura now. It's an enchantment. Let me make sure I understand how this works.
You gave me 4 in it. Or 5.
I gave you 5, yeah. You 17-22. Ay, ay, ay. Becomes a creature again if it's not attached to a creature. So in other words, if I kill the creature, it's a creature. If I kill this, it just goes away.
That's right.
Okay. Gotcha, gotcha. Because I have a pay one extra. I have a then we're not gonna be able to do well it's okay, we're not gonna be able to do both of those anyway. A dismantling blow. Destroy artifact or enchantment, draw 2 cards.
With kicker?
Yep, with kicker. Show me the counterspell. And then here come the 2. See what I get. Okay. Whale. Oh, you were... What are you guys doing? There's so many silly things I can do right here. How's about we... How many cards in hand? 3?
3.
Crystal Shard has to be blue mana. So Dimir Guildgate. Targeting, say, Hypersonic Dragon. No, it has haste, but I get to tie up your mana.
I'll pay 1.
Okay. Trap her down. In that case... Do I give it flying? If I don't give it flying, if I do give it flying, it's just straight damage. If I don't give it flying, he maybe loses a creature and draws a card. Man. Decisions. Do I give him a card? Nope. There we go. Blue, red, has flying.
Alright.
Swing 7. And then, pass turn. So, my maximum hand size is also reduced by 1, right?
Yeah, so...
There goes Gnarled Pack. Sorry, buddy.
Bloodbraid Elf.
Hi, Bloodbraid. That seems pretty good.
Madcap.
Well, can't go on the Bloodbraid because he's on the stack, but everything else...
Let's see. Who do I want it to be on?
That is a good question.
I think I want it to be on the...
Hypersonic?
Yeah, I kind of think I do, but it's a lot to put in one basket.
It is. So obviously I only have one creature that can block a flyer since Interloper states he can't. But, yeah. It is a lot.
But you probably would have killed him by now if you could.
I mean, I just tried to unsummon it with a... with one mana open, with one mana for you to pay. So, yeah, if that doesn't say something. I like your idea, actually.
So I put on one wolf, or young wolf. Then, yeah.
Yeah.
It doesn't really, I mean, you could just redirect damage. So going face is the place.
Do as much with one attack as I did to you last turn with two creatures.
And I'm going to play Wrecking Ball on Chromat.
I don't have the mana to save it, nor do I have the Crystal Shard up. It's gone, baby, gone.
Tap land.
Swing 7,
8, 9, 10.
Yeah, you have haste. Well, actually, if the Bloodbraid is swinging, that might change. Okay. Well, we'll do the damage later.
Is it worth cashing in everything? Probably not. Just 7.
Okay. Just 7, then.
Good.
Coming up. Draw a card. So, shenanigans are about to happen.
Okay.
Mulldrifter, trigger on the stack.
Oh boy.
Crystal shard. Bounce baby back. Draw two.
How can you hold all these cards?
I can't. Not for long. That's the short answer. Not for long.
Hopefully they're pretty low cost. But I know there's a Cobra Climber in there, and that really defeats the purpose.
Yeah.
Having cards in hand.
All of these cards. So little time.
Should put a Reliquary Tower in here.
Well... You're not wrong.
Are there any better cards that that increase your maximum hand size? Like Venser's Journal, right?
Venser's Journal for 5 mana. What also gains you life.
How does it gain you life exactly?
Upkeep each card in hand, you gain 1 life.
That could be a cool card to put in here. I mean, there's really not a lot of sustained life gain. There's plenty of artifact hate to counter it.
That's true. So, we'll play a... 1, 2, 3. A Rocks War Monk.
Oh, yep. That's a good one.
We'll play...
It's very good with Eladamri.
A Nearheath Pilgrim, soul bonding to Interloper.
Nice.
For maximum cuteness.
I'll tap your... Oh, you're going to combat?
Yeah.
Tap Interloper.
Yeah, that's what we do here. Next.
And I guess no attacks. Sense.
Doesn't look like it, I'm afraid. Much as I would like to, doesn't look like it. That doesn't leave me with any flyers. Or creatures with reach.
Reachers, as they are known.
Yeah. That's a reach. I'll stop with the bad puns and discard an Archaeomancer, pass the turn.
Yeah, I think that is a flaw of this this battle box. Sometimes you discard your value cards because you have too much value.
Mm-hmm.
Need some more dorks.
That is a good problem to have. Like, if you're having to get to that point in the game.
Yeah. Draw one.
Yeah, the Mold Drifter was nice, but honestly, with a Hypersonic Dragon out, maybe I should have just kept it. Well, Madcap skills, so it wouldn't have been enough on its own.
Sting Scourger, War Monk.
Yep.
So, like, Pride Mage.
I am going to scooch it in just a bit. I guess keep it with the Blood Braid, gold and gold.
I'll tap your lifelinker.
Yep, Nearheath is tapped as well.
Swim with everybody.
Oh, the team. Okay. So, let's see. 1, 2, 3. How low do I want to go here? Right now, I would be taking 9, going to 6. I'm okay with that. So, we'll trade. will trade, but Young Wolf gets a counter. And then Stromkirk Noble gets a counter.
Oh, yeah. Okay. And I'll draw three.
Yep. Built-in value. Yay.
Okay. So... let's play... Nightscape Familiar and Judge is Familiar.
Nice. Okay. Fair enough.
Pass turn.
Top decks of glory. There's no Merciless Eviction, we know. That was last game. Okay. Well... One, two, three, four, five.
Slice and dice?
No. Sadly. Mole Drifter is flyer number one.
Okay.
Have to do something else, or I just lose. Oh, this feels bad, but we'll do it. We have to. Wait, we're just shy on mana to do that. How about instead? We sacrifice you, I think. Yeah, we do. It's a mana.
Mm-hmm.
Skin Render.
Ooh.
We're going to stick three counters. I think we have to do the dragon here, because we just die otherwise. Hi, Mom.
You can take that.
Hi, Mom. I'm okay. How are you? I have an answer. Bye.
So I just went on the swing back?
Yep. That'll do it. She's needing me to bend time and space. And unfortunately, that's not really my forte. Hmm. You know. I wish, but...
Tough.
No cigar. Oh, well.